Hello everyone. Today I am going to explain the concept of optical fiber communication is optical sources. So, optical sources is one of the important element in the communication system. So optical fiber communication is a communication system where information is transmitted in the form of light energy. So the information, it may be in the analog or digital, that electrical energy should be converted into optical energy to make into transmit through the optical fiber as a channel in the optical communication system. So optical sources, it should convert the electrical energy into an optical energy. So this will be the part of the transmitter at the communication system. So how it will convert the electrical energy into optical energy? So there are two main, broadly, there are two types of optical sources are used in the optical communication system. They are LED and laser. So LED is a light emitting diode, and one more, laser, is a light amplification by stimulated emission. So we will see one by one what is LED and laser. Before going to study LED and laser, let us see what are the basic requirements for the optical sources. The first one, it should have the size, physical dimension should suit the optical fiber geometry. That means it should have the size and configuration compatible with the launching light into an optical fiber. And the second one, it should have the narrow radiation pattern, narrow beam width, so that it can easily couple to the optical fiber with the any core diameter. And it should ability to directly modulated by varying driving current, and it should have the high output power to couple into the optical fiber, and they should emit optical signal in low loss window. So low loss window in the optical fiber communication are 850 nanometer, 1310 nanometer and 1550 nanometer. And it should be linear, and it should highly rigid and flexible. So these are the requirements for the optical sources. So how, like optical sources, it should generate the optical energy. How the basic concept of generating the optical energy, or how the emission of the light takes place. So it is basically, it will be classified into three processes as absorption, stimulated emission and spontaneous emission. So you can see the first diagram, it tells the spontaneous absorption. We can see here there are two energy state, E0 and E1 of the atomic system. Here initially atom in the lower energy level, when the photon means it is a light particle incident to the atomic system, what will happen? The atom in the lower energy state will transit into the higher energy state by absorbing the photonic energy with E1 minus E0 or HU. This is called as absorption. And alternatively, one more, spontaneous emission means when the atom already in the higher energy state, it will, so the transition from the higher energy state to the lower energy state takes place, and during this transition it generates the photon with energy H nu is equal to E1 minus E0. This is called as a spontaneous emission. This concept is used in the LED light emitting diode structure. But what do you mean by stimulated emission? This is another process in the generating mechanism of the light. It is also called as a amplification process. This concept is used in the laser. Actually here, photon with the energy H nu is equal to E1 minus E0 is incident into the atomic system, with the atom already in the higher energy level. So what we, this photon, incident photon, triggers the atom in the higher energy level, so that that atom will transit, it will drop into the lower energy level. During this transition, it generates the photon with energy same as that of the incident photon energy, and even the frequency also will be the same. These are the three process, basic concept, how absorption and emission takes place in the material which is used as a optical sources. So we will see what is LED and what is laser, how it can be used as a optical sources. So what is LED? So the basic LED operation, it consists of P-type material and N-type material. So here semiconductor materials are used to make the LED. So here P-N junction act as the active or recombination region. So here the input to electrical energy should be converted into optical energy. So here the P-N junction, when it is forward biased, electrons and holes recombine at the active region. So here few electrons and holes will radiatively recombine, and few will be non-radiatively recombine in the active region. This is a simple LED operation. So emitted wavelength after recombination, the photon is generated with the energy that is directly proportional to the band gap energy between conduction band and valence band. So here we can see in the diagram there are two layers. One is P layer and N layer are connected, and between two layer the junction is formed. That junction, where in the junction actually the recombination takes place, and that junction is called as a active region, where the recombination takes place. After the recombination, photon with the energy E1 minus E0, or the band gap energy between the junction barrier potential, is directly proportional to the photonic energy. So what are the material used for the LED or light source materials? So most of the semiconductor light sources contain tertiary and quaternary compounds like gallium, aluminium, arsenide, indium. These are the materials used for making the light source. So we can see here there are two combinations. One is gallium, aluminium, arsenide with the material or compound parameter X. By varying the X, we can change the wavelength. What is emission wavelength? We can select over the range 800 nanometer to 900 nanometer. And one more combination, material combination, is indium, gallium, arsenide, phosphor, where X and Y, two parameters are used to control the emission wavelength. It is around 920 nanometer to 1600 nanometer, and one more 1300 nanometer to 1600 nanometer. So these are the materials used for the light source material. Usually, already I have mentioned, to get the low dispersion, no, at a low attenuation, there are three windows, wavelength windows. One is 850 nanometer region, another 1300 to 1550 nanometer region. To get the 850 nanometer region, gallium arsenide and aluminium gallium arsenide materials are used. To get the second 1300 nanometer 1550 nanometer region, indium gallium arsenide phosphor and indium phosphors are used. In the LED, to get the complete total carrier confinement and light confinement within the core of the optical fiber, the LED should have some structure. It is called as a heterojunction structure. Heterojunction means there are two P and N materials are used with the different material composition. so that the junction will not be the both the junction, both side of the junction should not have the same material. So it is called it as a heterojunction. So it will make the low diffraction losses, and also it will be like it can use to confine the light optical confinement within the optical fiber core. How to make the heterojunction? So here it will be accomplished by modification in the material to control the index of the refraction of the cavity. So already we have studied in the optical fibers, it has two material, one is core and another one is cladding. Core always should have the higher refract index compared to the cladding. Why? Because core should confine the optical fiber properly, optical signal properly within the fiber, so that it should reach properly at the receiver end. So how to achieve this one? Because optical source should generate the optical energy, and it should be properly coupled to the optical fiber, so that it should have the high efficiency at the receiver end. So whatever the material used to at the junction with the should have the high refractive index. So it depends on the what are the impurities used and the doping level. So heterojunction region is actually lightly doped with the p-type material and highest index of refraction. So there are, this is the structure used in the optical sources. It is also called it as a double heterojunction, because heterojunction, there are two types. One is single heterojunction and double heterojunction. If you go for single heterojunction, the confinement of the light is less. There will be a light loss takes place. So double heterojunction is suitable for high efficient optical sources in the optical fiber communication. So here, the heterojunction means is a junction between two different semiconductors with the different band gap energy. The difference in band gap energy creates a one-way barrier. So there will be a light charge should transmit, all the charge to transfer to the active region or junction region for the recombination process. So here it is an important structure in the LED double heterojunction, and the layer of material with the lower band gap energy is sandwiched between the layers of the material with a higher energy band gap. It is called it as a double heterojunction. So there are two heterojunctions present on each side of the active material. So here double heterojunction forms a barrier which restricts the region of the electron hole recombination to the lower band gap material. So active region, we can see here there are like gallium, aluminium, arsenide of n-type and p-type. It acts as a confinement layer, and n-type gallium, aluminium, arsenide with the 1 minus YY, the combination, whatever the impurity added at the center is different than the n-type and p-type in the confinement layer. So that the center region, n-type, is act as active layer, recombination region. Actually, all the carriers from the n-type, from the confinement layer, from the n-type and p-type will be moved towards the recombination region, where the electron and hole recombination takes place. So in that region, the photon generates with the energy h nu, and wavelength is 820 nanometer. So that will be the active region. Both side of that active region with the different junction, with the different materials are used. That's why it is called it as a double heterojunction. So we can see here the recombination region with the higher refractive index compared to the confinement layer, and other substrate layer with a low refractive index compared to the confinement layer. So you can observe here the center region act as a core, or the active region should be coupled properly to the core of the optical fiber while collecting the optical signal. So that active region after recombination, the photons are generated and it will be confined within that active region so that it can be easily coupled to the core of the optical fiber, and the entire optical energy, whatever generated in the LED, will be transmitted towards the optical, through the optical fiber towards the receiver. So this is the concept in the optical LED, in the optical sources. This is a main concept, or this is the heterojunction structure used in the LED. So in the next class, I'll be going to explain what is the working of the laser. Thank you.